Hey, what up, YouTube? It's your boy, BIGWAYNES918, and I'm back with another POV for y'all today. You feel me? If you haven't done so already, like and subscribe to my channel. Okay? Like and subscribe to BIGWAYNES918. I've got interviews, food reviews, I got vlogs, and I got it all off of my channel. It's all the way lit over here, you feel me? See what I'm saying? Hit the notification bell, let you know my next video is dropping. Yes, sir. So without any further ado, we're going to go ahead and get into this, man. So today's POV is going to be on Michael Irvin. Yes, sir, Michael Irvin. Okay, y'all know who Michael Irvin is, you know what I'm saying? Dallas Cowboys legend, Pro Football Hall of Famer Michael Irvin. He's had a broadcast career for the last 20 years. And just last month, he was actually set to cover Super Bowl LVII. He's in the middle of an accusation of sexual misconduct.
Hell no!
Okay, he had a brief interaction with a lady who was working at a Marriott hotel, and a claim was made against him that he did something to... They're not saying exactly what it is that was done, but supposedly, I'm going to quote it, is sexual misconduct, okay? I don't know how else to say it, you feel what I'm saying? But off the top, you know, we knew that it was just a very brief encounter. It was a situation where he encountered someone, he ran into him in public, they exchanged some words, and then all of a sudden, there's a problem. We come across so many accusations like these. Man, honestly, when I first heard it, I felt like it was gonna be
some bullshit.
Okay, it sounds like a quick money grab.
Ah, oh, I want $150,000.
Or a smear. I don't foresee him doing something like this to screw up his career and to mess up them coins. They came on TV, they held a press conference. The video has actually been released. It is exactly what it looks like.
It's some bullshit.
Okay. Now, I don't know what was said to the woman. It appeared to just be some little small talk conversation. It didn't really seem to be anything major. A friendly encounter. They're reacting to each other. It didn't appear that any unwarranted contact was happening between them. Touching on the elbow. And I look at things this way. Like, when you're interacting with someone, like... And this is just a rule of thumb, even for me, with so much on nowadays. A handshake, a dap, fist bump, a hug. And if you family, it depends on how the hug is going to go. If somebody, you don't know, it's going to be the one arm. You know what I'm saying? You just never know. But definitely someone I would have kept my space with because of stuff like this. It's too easy to put some type of accusation on someone. But as you can clearly see in the video, nothing crazy was going on. She went out of her way to stop Michael Irvin to have conversation with him. And I realize some situations do happen where some of these celebrities, they mess up their own careers by doing things they shouldn't be doing, okay? This is not one of those situations here. Definitely a money grab.
Give me my goddamn money.
People try to catch up celebrities, cook up these wild stories, try to find areas of vulnerability to try to basically try to extort money out of someone, you know what I'm saying? And sexual allegations seems to be the biggest thing right now. That's the one where, you know, when people hear even just one allegation, whether it's true or false, man, people take their money and go a different direction. To some people, Michael Irvin is a sexual predator for life now. You got some people out there that's gonna call him a predator and all these other things behind this one allegation, which we know ain't true, man. This is some bullshit right here. You know it. Second reason behind this, maybe Fox and NFL have something against Michael Irvin that they did not want him to cover the Super Bowl.
Yeah, they rolling hard too. They slaying real good, real good.
Might have to drop a dime on them niggas.
It's either money grab or a smear. I don't know which one it is.
This is more than just work. You know, I'm in between big businesses here, businesses that make billions of dollars with and for each other. But when you get called in a room and you're said, somebody tells you, hey, pack your bags, you leave the duty, go home. You sexually assaulted somebody. If you're telling me I'm doing something and I do not know what I'm doing, you can't tell me to just go home. Our conversation was about football. She said she wasn't much of a football fan. And I didn't tell her. I said, well, you watch Calvin Sutton some shows. I said, you watch the show that I do. Watch First Take or Game Day Morning. I said, you can look those up. That's what we were just talking about. Whether I work again or not, I don't know. I don't know what happened with all of that. But what I had to know was, what are we talking about? What are you saying? I assaulted somebody, I attacked somebody, and you won't let me see it, and you're trying to send me home.
It's messed up that she would do something like that, and I hope they release the name. They didn't mention any names in this video of this press conference, but I hope her name gets mentioned, because people need to stay away from people like that. This right here is interrupting this man's livelihood. It's interrupting his coins. That's where I'm at with it, man. I hope the best for the situation with Michael Irvin. I know he and his counsel have filed a $100 million countersuit. $100 million! I don't think, they might get some money, but I don't think it's gonna be $100 million. But only time will tell. I like watching all the old school athletes, man. So I really hope he can make the best of his situation and get back on top of things. And honestly, when stuff like this happens, it's really making it worse on the people that really are victims of these situations. And so, like I said, this is a lie. Y'all can clearly see it from the video. I mean, it ain't hard to tell. So, yeah, that's all I gotta say about that, man.